What's going on, beautiful people? Welcome to another Haas Capital video. In this video, I just want to show you a couple of ways that you can safeguard your MetaMask account. You know, especially if you're now venturing out there, you're doing DeFi, maybe you're just doing all kind of borrowing and lending, you're swapping a lot on different exchanges. If you guys are starting to really follow me and you're doing just different swaps so you can have your wallet registered and programmed so that you get credit for these airdrops, you're leaving a lot of history behind of your wallet trails. And I just want to show you guys how to clean some of that history up and how to edit some of the transaction spends and the permissions that you guys are giving when you click yes and accept in your MetaMask. Now, I know when many of you guys, come on here to do a swap, you don't really know what's going on. Many people don't understand the smart contracts at all. So you just see it and it says, hey, would you like to give Uniswap permission to spend your tokens? And we hit yes, and that's it. We know we got some tokens and that's all. However, there have been exploits and expectations that have gone on. There have been hacks that have gone on. There's been all kinds of situations and things that have gone on through smart contract issues and different bugs and things that have come about where people have been drained and been liquidated because of infinite spend approvals that they have given to these smart contracts. So maybe you don't know what you're signing, but at least if you did just sign something, I want to show you how to clear it up and clean it up. So maybe you're out here and you're playing on one of these new exchanges that just came out and they're offering you 15,000% APR. And all you got to do is do a swap from this coin to get this coin and pool it on whatever their native coin is. Now, you can do the swap and you can do the pooling, but I just want to show you how to go back and clean it up when you're done with them, all right? So that way you don't have them lingering around. So let's just go ahead and jump into this. Now there's a couple of different ways you can do this. I've already shown you in a previous video before that you can go to Etherscan in your wallet. If you're on the Ethereum network, you would come over here to more and you just do token approvals. And from there, you would have to paste your address in and it would show you all the outstanding smart contract approvals that you have there. Now, I don't have anything on the Ethereum network because again, this is just my little test wallet that I use for the purpose of these videos. But I will go to the Matic wallet now because we've been doing some playing in the Matic wallet so I can show you how to do all the different things and the testing. All you do is come over here in your MetaMask. You hit view account and explore. It's going to take you to the Polyscan, which is just like the Etherscan, the Binance scan. Everyone's got their own scan. You would come over here to miscellaneous. And then you would go to token approvals the same way. On all the scans, it's the same thing, guys. You go to token approvals. You would come here, you would hit paste, search your address, and it will show you all the different contracts you interacted with that have access to your wallet and the approval amounts that you've given them. So here you can see on Aave, they have an unlimited approval to spend and do what they want with my Wrapped Matic. All right. Same thing you can see down here with USDC, unlimited approvals. But you can come and see down here that this Viper contract only has approval for $4. Again, when I get into different contracts and I get into different places that I'm not sure, I edit the approval amounts for how much they can do and how much they can spend. And I'll show you how to go ahead and how to do all of that. But again, you just see different things that are out here and unlimited. And this may scare some of you guys when you go on the first time, because again, from the very first network you interacted with till now, and if you've been using the same MetaMask for years, you will probably have a list that's long. And all you got to do is come over here and cut them off and end their unlimited reign and opportunity to spend on your contracts. There's an easier way to do this, and this is the way that I do it. I use the DBank tool. Again, we provided a video for you, and I introduce you guys to DBank as well as a couple of other portfolio managers out there to help you manage your DeFi positions a little bit easier, especially if you're lending and borrowing on different protocols. To do it on DBank is fairly easy. Instead of having to go over to MetaMask and click on each individual one and go to the individual scans like Etherscan, Binance scan, all you got to do is come over here to profile. On your profile, you can click the approvals and then you would just go to the different networks that are there and you can see what's been approved to spend on this network. So Pancake, I don't need you having an unlimited. I'm not connected to Binance. I'm only connected to Matic right now. So here, let's just do the Matic ones. So we'll go to Matic. And as you can see, the only people that have permission right now is Ave, and they only have permission for the most part to, again, infinite spend options that they have. Right now, there's only 480 on there, though. So if I want, I wouldn't close it off right now because I'm still using it. Once I close that loan, I'll go ahead and close it. But let's go ahead and let's edit a different network. Let's see another network that we probably got a lot going on. I do a lot on Avalanche to test out and play with. So we'll go to the Avalanche network. In approvals, we'll go to Avalanche and we'll see what's going on over here. Look at all this. I don't believe I have any dollars on my Avalanche right now, but we can close some of this out. I don't need Trader Joe doing unlimited spend on USDT. Oh, we gotta make sure there's enough funds to go ahead and cover that. Avalanche fee's getting a little high up there. $3 for Avalanche? That's a little bit much, but I'll go in and edit that. But again, I just wanted to really show you how to go ahead and do it. I guess we'll go to the Phantom Network just so I can actually give you a decline one and show you how to actually take it off. All right, so we're on the Phantom Network now. All right, approvals, Phantom. Who do we got? Unknown project. Let's go ahead and hit decline. Cost me 4 cents. But all I'm doing is taking off the contract and their access to an infinite spend of USDC. So again, it doesn't mean that they're going to go in there and do that, but what if something happens? What if the project's a shady project and they end up deciding, hey, we're going to go ahead and go after everybody who interacted with us? Well, now that I've taken them off, as you can see, that's it. They have no more permission to do any spend in my wallet unless I hit approve. All right. All these still have permission to go ahead and do spends in my wallet, but I'm still interacting with these right now. Like I got money sitting on Spooky Swap. I got a big loan in Magic Internet Money, and I've got bread sitting in Urine Finance right now. But I just wanted to show that to you guys because, again, I know a lot of you are now starting to go into DeFi. A lot of you getting a little bit more risky out there. So if you're going to get more risky out there, just protect yourself a little bit more if you can. And just make sure you turn off all these infinite approvals that you may have going on in the background. Hopefully this video was helpful, guys. Catch you on the next one.